उसमें जाओ। वेलकम फ्रेंड्स टू अनदर सेशन ऑन स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथॉन 2017। आई सर्टनली होप दैट सम ऑफ यू आर वेल अवेयर ऑफ दिस कंसेप्ट, बट दिस सेशन इज फॉर द पीपल हु आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट दिस कंसेप्ट and we and who would like to participate in this initiative. Basically, Smart India Hackathon is an initiative in which we expect all technology colleges in India, especially with computer sciences and IT courses, to participate. So what hackathon is? Many of the people might be wondering. So in simple terms, hackathon is digital product development competition. I do a lot of sessions with multiple colleges, and many people think hackathon has something to do with hacking, something to do with chori. Hacking is chori, hack is chori. But hackathon has nothing to do with hacking. On the contrary, when the word hackathon was coined, it has a very positive connotation. It actually meant doing things differently. It actually meant that how we can solve a problem innovatively. And we have not coined this term. This term was coined about 25 years back at Princeton. But now, hacks are done or hackathons are done very regularly across the world. And even in India, large number of private organizations are doing hackathons. For example, persistent systems. For last 7-8 years, we are doing hackathons. And for what we do hackathons? To bootstrap new ideas, to bootstrap new concepts. So what we usually do is actually take a bunch of ideas from all our employees. On a Saturday or a Sunday, we ask people to come and we do 36 hours continuous non-stop hackathon. Means what? We give team of youngsters, of our coders, our developers, problem statements or ideas, and they try to build product based on those ideas in 36 hours. And that's what this hackathon is going to be like this. The format is going to be more or less the same. So, briefly, hackathon is digital product development competition, and for Smart India Hackathon, we have a format of 36 hours. Means we will start at Saturday, on maybe in month of March, at 8:30 in the morning. Students will code, or team of students will code for 36 hours continuously. And on Sunday evening at about 8:50, the product has to be ready. The quick and dirty product has to be ready. The all features may not be working, but some good features need to work. So, in Smart India Hackathon, what we are trying to do is to engage students of engineering colleges to solve problems of our nation in 36 hours. As I said earlier, companies like IBM, Intel, Microsoft, Google, everyone does it. And this is a very, very established format. But for the first time, we are exploring how we can do it for nation building. How we can use the creativity, the energy of our students for development of our nation. So what we did this time? We went to various government organizations and ministries. So we went to about 25, 28 different ministries. You name them, like Ministry of Railways, Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Defense, Tourism, Postal Services, ISRO, Department of Atomic Energy, Health Ministry. And we sat with them. And we said, let's identify your problems, the problems which they are facing, which will make their life better, which will make their delivery to the customers or to the citizens better, how we can plug pilferages, how we can plug leakages, how we can plug corruption. We sat with them and we identified about 574 problem statements. These problem statements are currently listed on innovate.mygov.in. You can see that website on my side. So all these problem statements from various departments, we collected and we have listed them. And now we are going to all the engineering college students, especially computer science and IT students, and asking them to select any of the problem statement which they wish to solve. And send us the approach on how they wish to solve it. And we are asking students to participate by sending us the approach. So as I said, currently we have 574 problem statements already listed. We also have one section where you can submit your own problem statement or your own ideas, student speaks section. So that if you feel that I have not liked idea from what we have given here, you can also apply in that section whether you have your completely different idea or your problem which you are trying to solve. So even that is also there. We have listed. So what you need to do now is go to innovate.mygov.in, select any of the problem statement and submit your entry or an approach in the format which we have listed there. We only are accepting format or the entry submission in the format which we have given. We are not going to accept anything other than that format. So our aim is to reach out to all technology colleges in India and ask students to work on it so that together we will build this nation. So that together we can solve the problems which our nation is facing. I would like to share with you a grave, some good statistics, and you will understand what we are trying to do here. According to AICT, there are about 6,500 colleges in India and about 30 lakh students pursuing degrees in technology. So on an average, every student has to do 6 months of project work, right? So some degree people do 6 months of project work in their final year. Diploma students do 3 months of project in their final year. And PG, that is ME and M-Tech students, project work of about 1 year or 1.5 years. So for just sake of back of the envelope calculation, I'm going to consider that students are spending about 6 months in their 4 years courses for doing project work. So 30 lakh students divided by 4, because 4 year course, so it becomes 7.5. And if I have to convert this 6 months into a year, I have to actually again divide it by 2. So about 3.75 lakh man years. So 3.75 lakh man years of project work are done by students across India. But what is the output? The output many times is big zero. Because you also know, and I also know, what happens during this project works. A lot of copy pasting, a lot of actually resubmission of some things. And in some colleges, students actually go and buy the projects. So what we are thinking here is whether we can give students, whether we can challenge students with good problems which our nation is facing, and then use maybe 10, 20, 30% of the 6.5 man years of the effort for development of our nation. What this 3.5 or 3.75 lakh man years means? What? It means that 3.5 lakh students or persons are working for entire year and output is zero. So can we do something about it? And that's why with AICT, I4C, Persistent, NASSCOM, UGC, MyGov, we have all joined hands together and we are exploring how we can use this creativity, how we can use the out-of-box thinking of our students for our nation. But students have, you can forget about nation and nation building for a moment, but students can gain a lot for themselves. There are many things which students will get out of this. The first most important thing which students will get out of it is they will become better technocrats. For example, I will tell you, last year we did a pilot of this initiative in Pune, where we took problem statements from Pune Municipal Corporation, Pune Police, Pune Transport, and I spoke to about 18,000 students personally, and I challenged them with those problem statements. And people went ahead, developed their solutions. And as a result, they become much better technocrats. They all got great jobs. The reason for that is, when you are given a problem statement and you are asked to develop a solution, you actually go through the entire motion of product development. You will think about what should be my technology, what should be my architecture, what should be my UI, what should be my testing protocols, which algorithm should I use, as a result of which you become a far better technocrat. And that's very important. That will help you in getting jobs, that will help you even have your own startups. So this is the most important thing, that you will become a far better technocrat. Second, most important, is you will get opportunity to work on live projects. Many times when we have to do projects, we actually go to our profs, or we try identifying some of the projects ourselves. And we sometimes end up doing very, very theoretical exercise. From professor also, from where he is going to give us these projects. Because he has 100 students. He has to give projects to 100 students, 50 students, 60 students. How many different projects he can think about? So many times we end up doing a lot of academic exercise. And that's what we wish to change now. So we are giving you the problem statements on which you can go ahead and design projects, the problems which need to be solved, which our nation wants that we should solve these problems. So ability to work on live projects is the second most important thing. The third most important thing which we are looking at, you will get out of it, is that if you will develop a project, somebody is going to use it. You know, many times again we do the projects, and once the project is done, we actually submit it and nothing happens on top of it. But here, if you do a project, you are going to change somebody else's life. You are going to make somebody better, more efficient, so that they will give better services to the citizens. We can plug pilferages, we can plug leakages, we can plug corruption. And that's the third most important thing. Fourth, again, if some of you want to do startups, because there is a lot of craze about startups nowadays, NASSCOM has joined hands. And NASSCOM will actually handhold some of the best ideas to convert them into startups. NASSCOM has a 10,000 startup program. They have to create 10,000 startups. Government has asked them to create 10,000 startups. So NASSCOM is going to create 10,000 startups. So some of the ideas, or many of the good ideas from this project or from this competition will actually end up getting into startups, where you will get funding, you will get guidance, mentoring, everything. So this is the fourth most important thing. And the fifth of all is you will have great prizes to win. We have about 50 lakh worth of prizes. First prize is of 1 lakh rupees, second prize is 75,000 rupees, third prize is 50,000 rupees. But we have 25 first prizes, 25 second prizes, and 25 third prizes. We currently already have them. You know, and we are working with many more sponsors to get many more prizes. So we will have huge amount of prizes to win, and in different categories. Apart from that, now we are working with closely with Rediff.com, ZTV, MyGov is already there. So, lot of name and fame. So the people who are going to be winners or participating, even in participation, these channels or these news agencies are going to cover you. So you will get a lot of name and fame from these organizations. Apart from that,
certificates from ministries directly. No? So if you work for railways, for example, railway ministry in coordination with AICT will give you an endorsement. If you'll work for ISRO or DAE or some any other, they will actually go ahead and give you a certificate saying that you have worked for them. And post hackathon, you will actually convert your project or the product which you have developed during hackathon into a robust product. And you will work directly with the ministries. You will work directly with the government organizations. So what you need to do? First, as I said, go to innovate.mygov.in. Select your problem statement. Any problem statement based on your liking. If you want to work for tourism, go for tourism. If you are passionate about working for ISRO, go for ISRO. Steel ministry, go for steel ministry. Anything. What you are passionate about. So go ahead and do that. Okay. Then form a team. Six member team. Six members are very essential. Out of which one has to be a girl. So select a problem statement. Then form a team. Six member team out of which one has to be a girl. Create the document in the format which we have given, stating your approach or stating how you want to solve it. You know, how you are going to solve a particular problem which you have selected. We want only that approach right now. So go ahead and create that document and submit it to us. Last date of submission. Please, because I get a lot of these queries. Last date of submission is 20th of January, 20 January. But as we are getting a large number of entries, you have to fast. You have to be fast. Because if we get entries, large number of entries for a particular problem, we are going to switch off that problem. We are going to take that problem off the list. And we will ask people to go for other problems where there are no entries. So, do it as early as possible. Once your entries are done, we will actually go ahead and scrutinize these entries. So, we are expecting about 15,000 entries from across India. Out of which, 1,500 entries will be shortlisted. So, large amount of entries will be shortlisted. And these 1,500 entries will actually, or these 1,500 teams will actually do hackathons. And these hackathons will be organized in 25 different locations across India simultaneously. 25 different locations. So almost all cities we will have hackathons where teams are participating, competing to solve problems faced by the nation. So the actual hackathon will happen somewhere in end of March. We will notify you the dates soon. We are working with Prime Minister's office to finalize the dates. So the hackathon will happen, as I said, somewhere in March. And it will be on Saturday, it will start on Saturday and end on Sunday. So we are currently working on those dates. So during that actual grand finale of hackathons, as I said, 1500 teams will be competing, and each team has 6 members. But once your team is shortlisted, you will be allowed. Shortlisted means once your approach is shortlisted after sending your entry. So before actual hackathon, you will be allowed to have 2 mentors. So your team becomes now 6 members plus 2 mentors. That is 8 member team. As mentors will help you actually design strategy, design approach, design architecture, decide on technology stack so that your products are better. They will interact with you, they will guide you, they will train you. So that you, as I said, you will become much mature technocrats. So you can have either your professor as one of the mentors, or you can ask us as the mentors, or you can go ahead and take mentors from any industry. Maybe the alumni, maybe your friend, maybe anyone. So, again, I am repeating because I am getting a lot of questions on the same thing. Go to innovate.mygov.in, select any of the problem statements, form a nice team, a 6-member team, give it a cool name. Out of these 6 members, one has to be a girl, but all 6 girls are fine. Then create the document which we have told you. It's a 2-page or 3-page document, not more than that, highlighting your approach, and submit it to us before 20th of January. Once you have submitted, we will evaluate it, and then we will select 1500 teams. Once we have selected those 1500 teams, which we will be calling them as finalists, each team will allow to have 2 mentors, and this team can work with those mentors for about a month, maybe over Skype, maybe over WebEx, maybe in person, and then together they actually compete for hackathon, 36 hours hackathon at different locations. We will let you know based on which location you have to go. AICT will pay for your travel and stay if you have got selected for this hackathon. So that's in nutshell what you will get out of it. So we want your help on 2 major aspects. One, we want to have each and every college participating. So Ministry of HRD, AICT is actually tracking who are all participating and who are all not. So we want each and every college to participate. But we are going to allow only 3 entries per team. 3 entries per college. You know, please remember this, that we are going to allow only 3 entries per college. And the entries need to come from your official channel. Your principal, your dean, your director has to endorse that these are our 3 entries. We don't want more than 3 entries from college right now, because we are expecting large number of entries. But we want each and every college to participate in this, and we will be tracking, and we will be giving reports to HRD minister that which colleges have participated and which colleges have not. So that's very, very important. They are tracking with us. They want to do actual analytics. So please share this information with all your friends, with all your colleagues, with principals, with your faculty, that every college needs to participate. Second, please help us propagate this message that AICT is actually organizing something, some initiative for students where they can involve students directly in nation building. That's very, very important. Because we are now the dead brains. We cannot think out of the box. Youngsters can think out of the box. Novel ideas will come from youngsters. So, go ahead and share this page or this concept with all your friends, maybe over Twitter or Facebook or WhatsApp. You can also write to us if you have any queries at our email ID is idea@i4c.co.in. I am going to repeat, our email is idea@i4c.co.in. So if you have any queries, please do write to us. And our Twitter handle is India Ka Idea. India, I-N-D-I-A, Ka, K-A, Idea. India Ka Idea. So, you can get to us, you can write us, you can tweet about us on our Twitter handle, India Ka Idea. Also, we want each and every college which is currently participating in this session, please, please remember this. This is very important. This is for our records because we have to submit it to ministry. Each and every college currently participating has to put two photographs, has to take two photographs and email it to us. Without fail, please. So after this session, go ahead, click two photographs and email it to us. And for that, you can use our idea at i4c.co.in or another email ID is sih2017@outlook.com. SIH, that is Smart India Hackathon. So short form for Short India, sih2017@outlook.com. So these are the basic, this is the basic information, and now I will start taking questions from you all. So the first question which we have got, is the Spark supposed to register the team and ideas? The Spark is very, very important for us. He has to help us identify the teams, identify the ideas, do all the groundwork for actually submission of the ideas. But teams can go ahead and submit the ideas. Because you have to enter team leader, team name, and for every team it will be different. So students can go ahead and submit the ideas, but they have to upload the letter of endorsement from the college, and with Spark will be actually helping them in all this procedure. So students can register, but Spark has to support them. Okay. So the next question is, in the Spark registration form, we are required to fill AICTE registration number. Our university is registered with UGC. How can we give an AICTE number? Okay. Fill the UGC registration. If you have a UGC registration number, or write that write in that column as UGC registration, and we will take care of it. We will look into it. Okay. Or we will create another form for UGC registered colleges. We will look into it, send us an email or register into a form with putting that UGC registration. Okay. Where can we find the PDF format for submitting ideas is the next question. So the format for submitting PDF ideas or PDF is already there on innovate.mygov.in. So if you go to innovate.mygov.in and Smart India Hackathon, you will find all the formats, you will find all the rules and regulations, You will find some of the videos which are there, which will help you, which will guide you. Some FAQs are also there. And if still you have queries, please write to us. Next question. Which one? Please advise about the industry mentors, that whether it will be suggested by you or you have to arrange from the college. Both is possible. If you are comfortable with your some person as your faculty, as your mentor, go ahead and have him as a mentor. If you want someone from industry, write to us and we will try getting it for you. We are in touch with NASSCOM. We are in touch with ACM. So, we also are in touch with some of the networks where mentoring can be done. But if you are comfortable, because we will have two mentors for each team, you can go ahead and choose. But don't worry about it right now, because if your team gets selected, then we will think about mentoring. The only selected team will have mentors. All doesn't require mentors right now. So go ahead, submit your idea. If your team gets selected, then we will think about mentors. So next question is, after submission of ideas, when we will come to know if our team is selected for final or not? Very good question. The deadline for submission of ideas, as I said, is 20th of January. Okay, after receiving all the applications, we will have our panel look into those applications and we will take about a month or so. So by end of February, we will actually go ahead and declare the results. And we will declare the results on either AICT website or MyGov website or I4C website. So we will do that. And we will actually send out emails also to the winners or the selected finalists to start working on it. And we will work with them directly. If two teams propose similar solutions to a given problem, which team stands a chance to win? It's again a very good question. If two teams give similar ideas, we will select the team who has presented approach in a better way. So you have to take care that you explain your approach in a very, very good way, but without actually changing the format of the document. So that's the innovation which you need to do. So give us your approach in as systematically as possible, as pictorial as possible, if possible. And then based on who gives a better approach, we will go ahead and select those teams. Next question. How will be the projects be distributed among 25 centers? As I guess, one kind of domain will be at one location. Yes. So 25 centers will work for 25 different ministries. It means that one center will work for one ministry. For example, if we say a center in Pune is working for Ministry of Railways, then any idea or any submission by any group from across India will come to Pune and compete in hackathon in Pune. Another example, Ministry of Environment. If we say for Ministry of Environment, we have a center in Coimbatore. So all the people who have submitted ideas for Ministry of Environment will travel to Coimbatore and compete at hackathon there. So each center, one center will work for one ministry, so that it's easy for us to evaluate ideas, for judging ideas, and then subsequently actually giving out prizes and following up with them later. So that's the format which we are conceiving. And for the travel and stay for the students, AICT will bear the cost. AICT will actually reimburse the tickets which you will buy. So AICT will take care of that. AICT has already budgeted for it. Next question. Can one team submit multiple solutions for multiple problem statements? Again, it's a very good question. And the answer is no. One team should only submit solution or entry for one problem statement. We don't want teams submitting, same team submitting multiple problems, ideas for multiple problem statements. For example, we don't want one team actually selecting idea in railways also, in civil aviation also. No, we are not allowing that. Because if two or three of the ideas submitted by one team actually get selected, then which idea they will pursue forward in 36 hours? It's very difficult. So don't just go with one idea. But if your solution actually solves two or three problem statements, one solution, we are fine with it. Okay, so that's very important, and don't submit multiple ideas for the same thing. As I said, the team composition, because there is a next question, whether team from different colleges are allowed, and the answer is no. So all team members should be from the same college. Okay. All team members should be from the same college. We are not going to allow members from different colleges. But if the members are from different streams, different faculty, we are good. We are fine. Okay. For example, a team can have someone from mechanical, someone from civil, someone from computer science, someone from IT, someone from instrumentation. We are fine. The six members could be from different teams. Different faculties, we are fine. But all the six members need to be from the same college. Okay? Also, remember, please remember, this is programming competition. So, it is better that all the six members can actually go ahead and code. Very, very important. Otherwise, what you will do for the 36 hours? So you have to ensure that all six members should code, should have ability to code. Okay. Please advise about the industry mentors and whether it will be suggested by you or has to be arranged by college. I think we have already taken this problem statement. We have already answered this question that you can select your own mentors from your college or you can ask us. And we will try to find it for you. Okay? Another question which has come out. Which question? Sir, the ideas that we submitted and if selected for the final round in the hackathon day, whether we have to follow the exact idea or a little deviation is permitted. Little bit deviation is permitted, but major changes will not be allowed. Okay? So, go ahead and mostly you have to submit, pursue the idea which you have actually submitted. If any college wants to become a nodal center, what will be the procedure is the next answer, is the next question. So, if any of your colleges is keen on becoming the nodal center or the venue for this initiative, go ahead and apply on AICT website. AICT is actually asked, is open for this kind of submissions. So please go to AICT, fill the form. We have listed all the requirements for venue center or nodal center and go ahead and submit it. Okay, which is the next question. Can we select our problem domains for ourselves or we have to select it from a given domain? Yes, you have to select it from a given domain. Otherwise, again, we will be doing a lot of theoretical exercise. We want problems. We are keen on solving problems which need to be solved. And that's the reason we have worked with these ministries so that they will help us take the problem statements forward after hackathon. So, during hackathon, there will be a lot of judges coming from these ministries and they will look at the solutions which you have built. And if they like the solutions, then post hackathon, they will directly work with you in coordination with their IT team so that your idea is actually converted into product and implemented in the ministry. So we want students to work on the domains which we have specified, because we have support and backing from the ministry to take the selected solutions forward. Will you be providing laboratories or workshops for us? No laboratory, but we will try to do workshops for you. Some basic training sessions will be done, but mostly we will expect mentors to do actually work with you and do all those workshops, share with you all the technology, and that's the role of the mentor. Otherwise, why we require a mentor? So the mentor is expected to help you, to support you some of the things. But if we have to do some workshops, we will work with you, but that will be post our submission. So let's focus on that part later. Just let's focus on submissions first. Which is, what is the next question? Before the final date, whether we can edit our submissions. Currently, we are getting a lot of submissions, so we are not allowing editing. So what I would request you not to get into that. If you have still a lot of editing to be done, write us an email and we will try to help you out. But as a normal procedure, we are not allowing editing, because otherwise it will become very difficult for us to manage the ideas. Can first year or second year students participate? Yes, anyone can participate who is doing degree or diploma, okay, in that particular college. You don't have to be third year or final year students, anyone. In fact, last year the winners of our Digital Pune Hackathon were first and second year students, and they actually defeated third and final year students from many other colleges to win the trophy. So first and second year students can participate. As I said, we want all the students from the same college, but we are fine if the students are from different streams or different faculties, because nowadays there are a lot of mechanical students who can code, there are a lot of electronic students who can code, or instrumentation people who can code. So no problem. So next question is, yes, can we make teams students of different semester? Yes, as I said, of course, no problem, go ahead and do it. Next question. What after 36 hours? I would like to take the first question. After 36 hours, event is over, anything more? When the teams will work with the ministry? Yes, it's a very good question. What happens after 36 hours? The selected teams will actually go ahead and work for ministry. Okay, ministry will work with them, with the college, and the IP, the intellectual property of that, will belong to the students. NASSCOM will help them, if required, to convert those ideas into startups, and ministry will work with them to convert a quick and dirty, because in 36 hours you can only build a quick and dirty product. It's not a robust product, right? So post hackathon, the actual robust product development starts. Any other question? Okay, so can you open the list? I would like to take if I've missed something. So the one question is regarding hardware from students. So if there is a hardware component in the hackathon, what you will do? So what we are saying is that we are not going to pay for the hardware. If you have Arduino boards, Raspberry Pis, or some other boards which you are using, or some sensors which you are using, you can get those hardware along with you. Do the coding part during the 36 hours hackathon, and then while going, you can take that hardware back with you. The next question is, the idea PDF should consist of how many slides? I think we have already given the format. I think it's 2 or 3 slides. Just go and look into the format. We want you to follow the same format. Please do not deviate from the format. Okay, another thing, go to the list. I would like to take one. There are a couple of questions there. List, Word document, madam. If my idea is having a solution, I have already taken that. Will you provide the funds? Will you provide the funds after the acceptance of projects? No, we are not going to provide any kind of funds because you don't require funds. Okay? If you require small amount of money for your Arduino boards, or you have to get along with you and then take it back. College should take care of it. So I think currently the questions are over. If you still have questions, do write to us on this Facebook page and our team will actually go ahead and help you answer those questions or try answering those questions. Please, please, please do not miss the deadlines. Please convey to all your friends, all your faculty members, all your colleagues, your principals, that we need to participate in this initiative. AICT and more importantly, Ministry of HRD is going to track who all the colleges are participating. So it's very important for you to participate in this initiative. Circulate this message over WhatsApp. Circulate this message over Twitter, Facebook, and all other social media platforms. We will be having more such sessions. We will be, I will be again coming next week or a week later. And the announcement will be, or even in this week, we will make those announcements. And if any of your friends have not joined the session, please join us. If you have any queries, again, please join us and answer, and we will try to answer them. So, thanks. Thanks for joining this initiative, and thanks for supporting us. We sincerely appreciate. We hope that you will all submit this. So, before going, I would like you to show a small movie. So we have, which will give you some idea about hackathon. So please see the movie and then we can disconnect. Thank you very much.
India, 1.25 billion people, millions of challenges, millions of opportunities.
हर वर्ष कई मजदूर शहरों में काम करने के लिए आते हैं, काम करने के बाद में और कहीं और चले जाते हैं, जिसके चलते उनके बच्चों की पढ़ाई बीच में छूट जाती है। अगर ऐसी कोई डिजिटलाइज्ड व्यवस्था हो, जिससे उनको ट्रैक और मॉनिटर किया जाए, तो उन बच्चों के भविष्य के लिए अच्छा होगा।
90% Indian railway passengers travel in a segment of unreserved category, especially the local train passengers. We need a cost-effective system of reservation which can provide quick reservations and save time and money both of the passengers.
India is blessed with myriad of herbal and medicinal plants, but the problem is finding their geographical location. Using morphology and image technology, our Indian health sector can be improved by finding their geographical location of the medicinal plant.
किसी भी काम के लिए हम कहीं भी जाते हैं, तो हमें कई प्रकार के ID रखना पड़ता है, और कई बार छूट जाते हैं। तो हर जगह अगर thumbprint से काम चले, तो कितना इजी होगा।
Solutions that can build a nation. Idea that can change India. Innovations that can inspire the whole generation. Presenting Smart India Hackathon 2017. A Pan India 36-hour non-stop digital programming competition. Where young minds of India will provide real solutions for real challenges. A joint initiative by Ministry of Human Resource Development, AICTE, I4C, Persistent, NASCOM, Rambhau Malgi Prabodhini, NIC, UGC, and MyGov. to shape young talents and build nations simultaneously. Compete from 25 locations across India and solve real-time challenges faced by the nation. Offer digital and sustainable innovative solutions. Showcase your creativity, technological knowledge. Get recognition and win prizes.
The idea of Smart India 2017 Hackathon is a great one. There are a billion Indians and therefore a billion mouths, but there are also a billion minds. And what we are trying to do through this hackathon is to capture the imagination of these minds and challenge them with the problems that nation is facing. 20 ministries of the government of India have posed problems for which they will be seeking solutions, and solutions from whom? The very best of talent in India through the Ministry of Human Resource Development, so we'll be reaching out to them. The only additional part that I would like to emphasize is that, you know, making high technology work for the rich is very easy. Making low technology work for the poor is very easy. But making high technology work for the poor is very difficult. And I do hope that through this marvelous hackathon, we'll get solutions which will deal with the problems of the poor.
We have the largest number of engineering graduates coming out of India. Now, how this talent can be tapped to really create innovative solutions? Innovation is going to be a game changer for India's transformation in agriculture, in our rural development, in our Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, and many things like that. So we require new ideas, and we require these talents to be inspired. Our young engineering talents coming from our close to 6,400 colleges and more than that kind of things, really their ideas, and they can be anywhere. How they can contribute to India's development, and there are many frameworks exist for their contribution. So innovation and entrepreneurship is going to be the key issue. And that's why I see that hackathon can contribute to that.
The hackathon will fulfill PM Modi's vision for India. Startup India, Make in India, Digital India, Skill India, Stand Up India.
I had participated in Digital Pune Hackathon 2015 and was a part of Team Mavericks. We had secured the first runners-up trophy. It was always a matter of pride working with the government agencies to provide solutions to the problems being faced by our nation. It was always an overwhelming and unique experience as we got to know how to deal with the real-time problems being faced during the simulation. We got sensitized and closer view to the issues and became more competent in providing newer and newer solutions.
Share digital ideas for any field. Nurture digital innovations for any industry. Discover digital invention for any sector. Come together and build Smart India of your dream. Smart India Hackathon 2017. Come, join the spirit of empowering India digitally.
And do write to us, do keep liking us, subscribing us, and sharing all the information with all your colleagues. And we will have another session similar to answer some of your more queries, maybe on Friday. Do watch out for that announcement. So thank you very much. Let's together make this country better. Thanks a lot.